we interrupt our regular programming for a special weather report. We now go live to Bob Wise, President of the Alliance for Excellent Education and former Governor of West Virginia.
I'm Bob Wise with the Alliance for Excellent Education Action News Network. I've got breaking news on a potential storm over Washington, D.C. As Congress returns from its Thanksgiving holiday, how it deals with this storm will have a major impact on the nation's school children. The first component of this storm emerged out west in Wyoming, the home of Senator Mike Enzi, the top Republican on the Senate Health, Education, Labor, and Pensions, or HELP, committee. As it moved east, it merged with a high-pressure zone over Iowa, home of HELP committee chairman Tom Harkin, a Democrat. So in most cases, you're left with a dramatically destabilized and highly unpredictable storm system when an area of high Republican pressure collides with an area of high Democratic pressure. In this case, however, the Republican and Democratic pressure zones came together in an almost harmonious fashion and continued marching eastward toward Washington, D.C. Now, once in Washington, the storm gained momentum when it received support from Tennessee, the home of Senator Lamar Alexander, former U.S. Secretary of Education. It additionally absorbed strength from Colorado, the home of Senator Michael Bennett, former superintendent of Denver Public Schools. At one point, it looked like this fast-moving system from Kentucky, the home of Republican Senator Rand Paul, would disrupt our larger system and scatter it back across the United States. But a late compromise allowed the system to continue moving forward. So now let's zoom into a map of Washington, D.C. to look at what might become of our storm. So here's a storm centered over the U.S. Senate, where a bill to rewrite the No Child Left Behind Act, the Elementary and Secondary Education Act reauthorization, has been reported out of the HELP Committee. But it is in a holding pattern until it can be combined with a bipartisan bill that could emerge from the U.S. House of Representatives. So we have to watch this center over the Capitol. Now, looking out across Washington, D.C., there are two other systems that we need to keep an eye on. The first is hovering over the White House, where President Barack Obama has proposed granting waivers to states on certain requirements of No Child Left Behind. The second is over the U.S. Department of Education, where Education Secretary Arne Duncan is reviewing waiver proposals that have already been submitted from 11 states. In the coming weeks, we'll be keeping an eye on all these systems to see whether the Senate and House of Representatives can come together on a bill that could be sent to the White House and outflank the waiver option. If no agreement is made, then the two waiver systems could overwhelm the Congress, pushing the Congress out of the picture completely and controlling the education atmosphere in Washington, D.C. until after the next presidential election. Stay tuned to the Alliance for Excellent Education Action News Network in the coming weeks for complete coverage of these issues. The outcome will determine whether the nation's school children will be seeing sunny skies or dark storm clouds.